हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द फिक्स्ड डोज कॉम्बिनेशंस। सो व्हाट आर द फिक्स्ड डोज कॉम्बिनेशंस? व्हेन टू और मोर ड्रग्स आर कंबाइंड टू गिवन एज अ सिंगल प्रिपरेशन, इट इज नोन एज फिक्स्ड डोज कॉम्बिनेशन। सो फॉर एग्जांपल, अ ड्रग ए एंड अ ड्रग बी आर गिवन एज अ सिंगल प्रिपरेशन, देन इट इज नोन एज fixed dose combination. And why we use fixed dose combinations? Let's see by an example. For example, amoxicillin and clavulinic acid are given in a fixed dose combination. Amoxicillin is an antibiotic of penicillin group, and problem with the amoxicillin is that it is destroyed by the bacterial enzyme beta lactamase, and when combined with clavulinic acid saves it from degradation by the bacterial enzyme which is named as beta lactamases. Now the advantages of the fixed dose combination. One of the important advantage is the convenience in dose schedule and better patient compliance. For example, in anti-tubercular drugs we have to give multiple drugs, and if these drugs are combined in a single preparation, it is easy to remember and easy to take, and there is enhanced effect of the combinations. For example, levodopa plus carbidopa. Levodopa plus carbidopa, this combination is given in the Parkinson's, and as we all know, it is the central nervous system disease, and we want levodopa to go into the central nervous system and provide dopamine. But the problem is that it is converted mostly into dopamine in the peripheral tissue, and the combination, if given with carbidopa prevents its peripheral conversion into dopamine and make it more available to the central nervous system. So the dose of the levodopa is reduced to nearly 75% if given with carbidopa, and it also minimizes the side effect. As we seen in the example, levodopa dose is reduced to nearly 75%, and its side effect like vomiting and tachycardia are also reduced. And the combination sometimes given to prevent the resistance as in antitubercular drugs. Now the disadvantages of the fixed dose combinations. The dose of any component cannot be adjusted independently, like in amoxicillin plus clavulinic acid, a fixed dose combination is given, and if you want to adjust the dose of a single content, then it cannot be done. The pharmacokinetics must not be widely different. As we have seen the example of amoxicillin plus clavulinic acid, the pharmacokinetic properties of these both drugs are nearly same. T half is nearly 2 hours for both of the drug, and other pharmacokinetic properties also. But if we want to combine two drugs whose pharmacokinetic properties are very much different, then it is not possible in the fixed dose combinations. And if there is if any of the drug causes the harmful effect, then it is difficult to identify which one is doing this, and sometimes beneficial effect also. So it becomes difficult to identify one particular drug which is causing harmful or beneficial effect in fixed dose combinations. And there is increased risk of toxic effects, especially if there are overlapping side effects, like a fixed dose combination of paracetamol plus aciclofenic is given, and paracetamol is hepatotoxic and aciclofenic is hepatotoxic, and if given together, the hepatotoxicity is increased, and chances of hepatotoxicity are more if both drugs are given together. And there will be increase in price if unnecessary drugs are included, and sometimes one of the drugs in the combination may be wasteful, and we called wasteful or sometimes harmful, and this type of combinations are known as irrational fixed dose combination, and we have to avoid irrational fixed dose combinations. Hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks a lot.